Hello and welcome back to Quotes by Carmel. I am Jill Carmel and it's my birthday, y'all. Yay! We're gonna party like it's my birthday. We're gonna drink. Wait, I don't drink. We're gonna buy fabric like it's my birthday. Yay! It's my birthday and I am surrounded by my two favorite heart quilts. The first one is my exploding heart quilt over here. It's made with Modern Love, makes my heart go pitter patter. And then, of course, is my Tula Boho Heart, makes my heart pound. But I love them both. And for my birthday, I'm going to celebrate in a heartwarming kind of a way. And I want you all to celebrate with me. So I have some. I have gifts, but they're different kind of, they're downloadable gifts. That's what I'll call it, okay? We are going to make some heart quilts, okay? I have gotten EQ8, and I have had some fun, y'all. Really had some fun playing with this, okay? So let me just show you kind of what happened. What had happened was, all right, we're going to start out. This was my first one. I think I named it Double Heart Log Cabin Quilt, something like that. It takes 70 solid blocks, and you can have them any colors, and then 6 solid background blocks, and then 24 half and half. And this will make, this is 92 by 92, so these are 9-inch blocks for this one, okay? But these are log cabin blocks, so you can make them any size you like, and you make the quilt top any size you like. So that was my first mock-up, okay? Then I got excited, y'all, and I did a purple mock-up. Love it, don't you? I love it, I love it, I love it. But I have a lot of purple going on, y'all. So I'm like, no, Joe, you gotta have to get out of that comfort zone and do something a little different than purple. So I decided to do black and white for a couple of reasons. I love this fabric. It's called Flair Noir. And in February is Black History Month. So I thought I could tag it into that. Doesn't that look fab? This is 6.5-inch blocks, okay? And, oh, I don't have the size. And it takes, where is it? It takes 68, no, it might be more. You know what? I'll give you the breakdown a little later in this video for this one, okay? And then I was like, oh, great. So I called this one Double Double Log Cabin Heart because I have 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, that's how my brain works, guys. And I said, ooh, well, log cabin is kind of just like a half square triangle, so let's do it in half square triangles. So I went, bam, and I decided to use fabric this time, you guys. This is lighthearted, okay? And this is my, what did I call it? My double lighthearted half square triangle quilt. A lot of words, y'all, but basically it's a double heart. 1, 2. This one was cute, but then I said, what if I make one just like the other one? Bam! So this is the one I'm gonna make, all right? And I am using charm packs. I'm using what I got from Fat Quarter Shop. Let me see, let me just show you. All right, so sampler box, I think it was November. We got 3 charm packs, which will be more than enough. And then I have all this leftover white on white from Camille's Nantucket line. And I am gonna put them together and I am gonna make this quilt top. I'm super excited. I think it'll be super cute and it's very quote unquote lighthearted. So I won't be making this from my fabrics, okay? I'm going with this. So I'm gonna put this in here. So I got a box and everything. I'm ready, guys. I'm ready for this one. All right, ready, set, let's get lighthearted. Yay! Today, we are going to lay out the double lighthearted half square triangle quilt top. Yay! I'm just going to put this on the wall for inspiration. And let me go over the blocks that you need really quickly. You need 156 blocks, okay? 60 of them you need as half square triangles. And I have already got mine done. I'm trying to grab them for you. And they're already squared up, and I've already put them in different colorways. This is like, I think it's like a salmon or coral. Not quite coral, I think it's more salmon. And there's the light pink, there's the aqua, and then there's the red. Remember, I'm not using the green in mine, okay? I'm just sticking with these colors, okay? I squared them all up to 4.5 inches. All of the blocks in this quilt top is 4.5 inches, and I use this ruler. How did I make them? I made them by taking 30 print 5-inch squares and 30 background 5-inch squares. I put them right sides together, and then I drew a line, diagonal line, and I sewed on either side of the line. Can you see that? I hope you can. Then I just cut them. And then I squared them up, and I have 60. Yay! All right. What about my background? My background was super easy. It's 18 background squares, and I just squared them to 4.5. All right. What I did is I cut 4.5-inch strips and then cut 4.5-inch blocks. Okay? Just need 18. 1/8. And then for my prints, you need 78. I don't know why I'm doing that with my finger, but it is what it is. I've already cut those down. I had more than enough to do this quilt top, those 3 charm packs. However, if you have a bunch of lights in yours, maybe use a layer cake and take those lights out. And that will give you more of a solid print, if that's what you want to do, okay? It's yours. You could do it your way. All right. So I am going to get started, all right? We're going to lay out this quilt top. All right. Hey guys, it's done, and isn't it gorgeous? It is absolutely gorgeous. I love how I took this, which was in my head, and translated it down to this actual quilt top. Turned out fabulous. I love it. It is 54 by 60, and I'm in love with yet another heart quilt. I will say that I did have to tweak and twerk a little bit because I did not use the green in Lighthearted. So all this green fabric, I did not use it. Let me see if I could show it to you. So anything that had too much green, I just did not use it. Let me show you, like here, and there's another one that I didn't use. Oh, here it is. So I did not want the green. I wanted it to be aqua, pink, red, and the salmon color, all right? So I was a little short on my blocks. So I had to go into my Bonnie and Camille stash, and I used about 3 blocks of this. It's called Handmade by Bonnie and Camille. I had to use a block or two from Shine On, the reds in there. And then I used this Early Bird, I think it is. I used probably 5 blocks because I needed some half square triangles. I also used a little Bella Solid because I had so much aqua and I really wanted to balance out the quilt a little better. Okay, I'm gonna show it to you guys. I'm loving it. I did good with my points too. Let's pick this up. Sorry about the noise. There we go. Didn't that turn out cute? Look at that. Sorry about the shadows, but I just think the points turned out fab. Yay. All right. So this, where is it? Will be available on my website, quiltsbycarmel.com. All you have to do is go to my website, sorry, and download this mock-up. All right. Now you will need to know how to make a half password triangle block. Okay, that's the only requirement, and you should know your quarter inch seam. If you want it to be square, you're going to need your quarter inch seam. So go ahead, download it, and if you make a quilt top, I would love it if you put hashtag quilts by Carmel when you post it on social media, whether that be Facebook, Instagram. You can post it on my Facebook page, which is Quilts by Carmel. I would actually love to see the quilt tops that come out of it. And if you use a different size, if you wanted to make a queen size, you could do 8.5 inch blocks, you know? You could just have a ball. You can take two layer cakes and make a queen size quilt top. Of course, you still need your background, but that would be fantastic. And for this top, I just used 1 yard of the Nantucket white on white, and it turned out fab. So after I made this, I was like, oh, it's so gorgeous. And I know I said I wouldn't make another purple quilt, but yes, I did it, guys. I looked in my drawer and I saw this purple charm pack of batiks. It's called Purple Passion Batiks. And oh my goodness, I forgot that I had it. I thought I had given it away. But look at these purples, y'all. So guess what I did? Yeah, I made another. I made a wall hanging and it is just super cute. Let me show it to you. Oh, here, I'll show it to you here first. Didn't it look cute? Isn't it cute, guys? I absolutely love it, love it, love it. This was made with 2.5 inch squares. I took my 5 inch squares, and what I did is I took 15 of them. Let me see, where is it? 15 5 inch squares and 15 background, put them together, and I would say right sides together, but it's batik, so it really doesn't. And both are batiks, okay? That's what I used on mine. I sewed all the way around, then cut on the diagonal twice, and then squared those 4 blocks up into 2.5 inch square triangles. And it just came out fab, guys. And look at this. Don't you think this right here, doesn't that look like a heart? Yeah, it looks like the heart sign to me. So maybe I have to change the name of this quilt top. But it turned out fantastic. And this would be a great retreat project. Wouldn't it just bring your scraps, 2.5 inch squares? You can bring any colors, and then you only need like a quarter yard of background and or a border. If you don't want to put the border on, it looks fab too. So I just absolutely love how this turned out. Yay! It's a little bonus project, right? Wouldn't it be great if someone did it in 1 inch squares? That would be like, I say 1 inch, but I mean 1.5, finished at one. It would be 12 by 13, and then add like a 1 2 inch border maybe. Yeah, that would be fun, but that would be a super cute project too. So you could just make it any size that you like it. I think that's what I love about this project. The size of the block dictates, sorry, the size of your quilt. So you can make it as big or as small as you like. Yeah, so yay! I absolutely loved it. All right, up next, I am going to work on my double double log cabin heart quilt. I got it all out. Let me move this aside and we're going to go over it really quickly, just really quickly. All right. All right, here it is. And it is basically this quilt top mocked up into log cabins. So if you think about it, you could do this any kind of way. If you like string blocks or crumb blocks, and then you just put you a consistently colored, because it doesn't have to be light, background, that would be cool. You know, that would be a great idea. I wish I would have asked some of my quilting friends to do that. I didn't think about that till just now. But guys, come back next week and we are gonna do the double log cabin quilt. I got it out, yay! And I am using these colors. I am using pre-cut. I am using Flair Noir by My Mind's Eye, Riley Blake. And here's all the different colors. I love when they do this and you can just see what you're getting. So I am using pre-cuts. I'm gonna use this 10-inch squares. I'm going to use fat quarters and fat eighths. And I'm hoping I will have enough to make it, because this quilt top is gonna be probably 80 by 86. It's a very big quilt top. Yay! I will come back with some ways that we can make a 6-inch log cabin block. Just a couple of options for some of you that may or may not know how to downsize your blocks, okay? I'm super excited, and I hope you take these downloads, because they're all, I'm gonna make all three of them, yeah, I was thinking about it, all three of them available on my website, quiltsbycarmel.com, and you'll just go ahead and download them, and you can get started in making hearts for my birthday month too. But I think it would be super fantastic if you make it for someone that maybe is going through something and needs a little love. So make it a pink one for breast cancer. Make a red one for Valentine's Day or Women's Heart Health Month. Make a purple one for pancreatic cancer or Alzheimer's disease. You could make a gray one for brain cancer. You could make a rainbow one. You could make a scrappy one. Oh, that would be good. You can throw your whole kitchen sink in and then just have a consistently colored background. Wouldn't that be great? That's a great idea. This would be a great scrap buster. So yeah, so come back next week. Next Thursday, we are gonna have the log cabin double log cabin heart quilt. I got it out. If you would, I would love it if you post on social media or, social media. So Facebook or Instagram, hashtag Quilts by Carmel. So I can see it, or you can even post it on my page. I have a Quilts by Carmel Facebook page. And I would love to see it, if anyone makes these quilts. I'm having a fun time and I want you to have a fun one too, okay? So thank you guys for stopping by. If you would, please like, comment, and or subscribe. Tell me, what color are you gonna make your heart in?